as far as, you know, and putting up with ever and putting up with us and all that stuff. There's a small token of our appreciation. We have a card in there, a gift in there for you from the Times Herald. And we wish you a ton of success. It's not going to be fun dealing with all this without you. You've had, in my opinion, you have one of the toughest jobs in the newsroom, and you've done a phenomenal job with it, and really appreciate it. Totally.
You know, I just want to say, we were actually talking in my office earlier today, and I told her that, believe it or not, this is, it was one of my first moves that I had to make when I was the managing editor. It was like just a couple weeks. I can't remember exactly, but the woman who was doing obits kind of in the morning and stuff, she worked in the business office. I can't remember. Kind of a smart ass, but you know, we got along. So she quit, or she was going to leave, and I remember I was in Joy's office and I told her. You know, so we were like trying to figure out, you know, what should we do? And Bill Fitzpatrick was in there, and he said, I wonder if Judy would be available. And so Tom Donahue was in the office, and I said, hey, Tom, they mentioned Judy. How would I get home? And he says, oh, I'll drive, you know, because the store in Portville, he goes, on my way home, I'll stop there on the way. And so then that's how it got started.
And if you listen, anybody else but Tom, I probably would have been, you know? Tom's such a sweetheart, you know. And we talked about it, and I thought about it. You know, the first, or the 5 years before that, when I left, you know, they wanted to have a party for me, and I said, no way. You know, if it had been my idea to put, we'd have had a party. But they threw me out the door, so yeah. I didn't want a party. And then, you know, Kate Evans took over the obituaries, and in my opinion, honest opinion, I think she was a piece of dead wood there. Anyways, they got rid of me. And she had to have help with everything she did, but they kept her. And so, you know. That just kind of rubbed me the wrong way, but I had 5 years to think about it, and then Tom gets it.
Cool.
And I'm thinking, you know, I can do as good a job as Kate did, probably a better job. So that's the reason I came back.
Well, and I will tell you that, you know what, I've had to make choices and I've had to make decisions, but I will tell you that for sure that was one of the best that I ever made. And not, you know, not because it was easy, because, you know, you had a track record, and, you know, a lot of people who I respected at the time, you know, had nothing good to say about you, so it was an easy decision, but it was one of my best ones, and I still stand by that today. I've made some good ones, and I've made some not-so-good ones, but that was one of the better ones.
Thank you. And
I will tell you, I remember, I didn't remember this earlier, but I just remembered it a little bit ago. When she came in, you know, we talked, and, you know, everybody remembers Roy, and Roy being Roy, he gave me a figure, you know, and I go, well, how does that sound? And she goes, well, that doesn't sound too good. That's what she said. And so I said, okay, well, give me a chance. And so I went back to Roy, I said, hey, listen, we got to get it squared away, you know, let's get real. And I'm sure it never needed, you know, that, you know, what it should have been, or what it, you know, probably should have been. But, you know, we made it work. And I remember that too.
Yeah, really. That was.
And then, but, you know, it was.
And it's not your fault, I know. You don't make the big decision, but it never got much higher than that either. These 10 years, you know. Plugging along there, you know.
Right, I know.
You got to work with us.
I know.
Judy, I know all the funeral home directors appreciated you being here, and all the families appreciated you being here. Funeral home directors and the families that we have to serve appreciate you.
Bob Gunter's crying into his beard right now.
Well, because we all know how much they can deal with change. You know, so I'm sure that they're real pleased with what's going on. But they'll have to get used to it.
But I'm sorry, whoever, I was going to forewarn Sally Gunther that you really got to clean up your copies for other people, because, you know,
buy a computer for
can just say.
Yeah. Oh, Bob hasn't bought a computer yet?
Nope.
No.
Nice.
My wife's grandmother recently, they did the funeral through them, and she, I overheard her bragging almost to somebody that she has no clue how to use them.
Well, they got a world-class Christmas light display out there. No computers. It's all right.
Well, they're
she gets her computer.
Stanley.
Yeah.
Stanley down there.
And then she scribbles out everything.
Oh my God. It's gotten a whole lot worse. We didn't need to do that, but.
Oh, Denny
Fuchs. No. You're just the only person that I know that would smile after dealing with Kevin
Fuchs
and do some berry. I wasn't smiling. I wasn't real proud of myself. I got pretty mouthy, but sometimes you have to, you know. Not too many. Most of them to work with.
I'll tell you real quick, everybody, I'm not saying that you're allowed to do this, but when I was a reporter in Bradford, remember the Troms? Remember the Smetport? It was one of those deals, and this is the first time this really started to happen. You know, now these fractured families. So there was two groups I was dealing with. There was the funeral director and the people who were, like, quote unquote, in charge of the body. And then there was some young, like, wife, you know, who was trying to get.
Wife number two.
They wanted two obituaries. They wanted the and she wanted hers. And I made the mistake of literally telling her to pack something up, you know. And so Mrs. Drum got on the phone. She's yelling at me. She's like, listen, buddy, and stuff like that. And then finally, I was like 24 years old. I said, listen, I'm not going to sit here and take this from some undertaker's wife. And I hung up the phone on her. That was my worst clash with So it's tough, but you know, it's part of what we do, and you did it really well. There's just no question. There's always no question about, you know, I said it earlier today, scrupulous accuracy, attention to detail.
Well,
that's important.
My thought was, you know, let's try to get it right the first time. You know, because those people that are dead, this is their last hurrah, you know, and you want to have it something fairly decent. So,
sometimes it's their only time. The only time they're ever going to be in the paper.
Yeah.
That first and last hurrah.
But you know, the other thing too is, like, I will say this, we talked a little bit about it earlier today. You know, it's a good time for you. You know, you still have a ton of energy and you're going to be able to enjoy it. You know, you still have the store, so you've got, you know, not just ending everything. But you're going to be able to travel because everybody knows you like to travel, your Vegas trips, your Florida. You know,
well, on the downside, you got to spend all that time at work.
Watch your chair.
So, you know, it's good for you. And who knows, maybe 5 years, you'll be bored, and an opening will be there, and I'll send somebody to drive by the liquor store, and who knows.
That would be really embarrassing to come back 4 times. Yeah. 3 times. I just keep coming back.
Well, see, who knows? Maybe I can bring that figure up.
Okay, you work on it. We'll see.
And also you should know too that hopefully that maybe whenever there's a little bit of spare time that maybe you can swing by the office and say hello to somebody at all.
And I will say, when I left, before I left today, there were two obits. I almost brought them by tonight because I knew there would be a crazy.
Well, you got to look, she's giving you money.
Yeah.